Hi, welcome. I think this is episode number 5, and we are supposed to be today discussing on photography basics, specifically on what? I think we have got the chat working today, so please type in, and I'm sure you already know, aapko pata hai ki hum kiske baare mein baat kar rahe hain aaj, right? So, aaj hum photograph ke peeche ke kahani, uske baad ki kahani ki baat kar rahe hain. Aapne photo khinch liya, bahut baar aisa hota hai कि आपको फोटोग्राफ एग्जैक्टली वाओ नहीं होता है और मे बी देर आर टाइम्स व्हेन यू डोंट गेट इट राइट. सीख रहे हैं अभी, आप सीख रहे हो. कभी ब्लर हो गया, अगर मोशन ब्लर हो गया फिर तो कुछ नहीं कर सकते हो. समटाइम्स इट्स अंडरलेट, ओवरलेट. देर आर वेज टू मेक योर पिक्चर बेटर. इवन इफ यू गेट अ परफेक्ट पिक्चर, इट स्टिल बिकम्स अ वाओ पिक्चर. सो जो पहली बार हमारे शो पे आए आज, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू that this is the fifth session where we are today going to discuss. We have already discussed a lot of things. I'll just quickly go through it. So we were planning to do 5 series initially. Today is the fifth, so aaj basically khatam ho jana chahiye tha. So you tell me, right to start with, I've got the chat on. You tell me if you want one more session, because we have not discussed about lights, flashlights, लाइटिंग का बेसिक जो, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गिव यू कॉम्प्लिकेटेड स्टफ, बेसिक जो रूल्स होते हैं उसको कैसे, लाइक आई एम श्योर लास्ट सेशन हम लोगों ने रूल ऑफ थर्ड्स किया एंड आई रियली वॉज वेरी इंप्रेस विद द फोटोग्राफ्स दैट यू गाइज वर क्लिकिंग, बिकॉज दोज फोटोग्राफ्स आर रियली ऑसम. सो रूल ऑफ थर्ड्स, जस्ट फॉलोइंग बेसिक्स रियली मेक्स अ बिग डिफरेंस. सो सिमिलरली लाइटिंग टू मी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट फॉर एनी फोटोग्राफर एटलीस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. I'm not saying you can change the side, you can't change the angle of the sun or a light, but if there are ways you can do it, you'll definitely figure out ways. So type if you want one more session on light specifically, so we'll extend it to one more session. But from our side, I think at least from my side, I would like to do lights, honestly. So type in if you want to. I can't see the chats coming in, or maybe I can't. It's again the same problem, it's not there on my phone. So maybe I'll keep seeing the screen. Oh wow, I'm just getting a 10 second delay today. So use your chat so I can read your chats ASAP. So 5 sessions humne bataya aapko. Pehla session mein we talked about camera, lens, understanding exposure. I'm sure you guys understood a lot. So photography, there are two types of it, as I told you, creative and documentation. Creative karna hai, bindas karo, documentation karna hai. And honestly, I'm telling you, don't go into too much of specifics ki isko artistic karna hai, ye karna hai. जो सिचुएशन वहाँ पे है उसमें एक मूड होना चाहिए, उसमें एक मैसेज होना चाहिए. अदरवाइज डोंट क्लिक इट. इट हैज़ टू बी लाइक देर इज़ अ मैसेज, देर इज़ अ कम्युनिकेशन दैट्स हैपनिंग, एंड दैट्स व्हेन यू क्लिक अ फोटोग्राफ. डोंट जस्ट क्लिक फॉर द सेक ऑफ क्लिकिंग इट जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव अ कैमरा, बिकॉज आई एम टेलिंग यू टाइम एंड अगेन, अ कैमरा इज ओनली अ डिवाइस. अगर आप ब्रेन यूज़ नहीं करोगे, सो यू एज अ पर्सन यू आर एज गुड एज जस्ट अ कैमरा. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू take it beyond that level, you have to use your brains and see how you can take this journey. It's a personalized journey. मैं अपने journey के बारे में शुरू में आपको सब लोगों को दिखाया अपने अलग अलग photographs, अलग अलग types of photographs. ISO shutter speed is what we discussed, aperture, what we discussed on session 2. I'm sure you guys have got it right. अभी तक थोड़ा बहुत फंडे समझ में आ गया होगा. It's how to create depth, how to separate your image, foreground versus background, how to ensure that you get a very silky watery touch to it, there you are. So these are things that kam rakhoge to wo information ko aapko balti ko full karne ke liye post mein badhaoge, but kam details ke sath jab aap khelte ho, then you will get a grainy picture. So always ensure that you get a right exposure. I'm not saying you'll always get a right exposure, but try to achieve right exposure. And honestly, a lot of times when you're on location, you don't realize. पहली बार मेरे को रियलाइजेशन हुआ, स्पेशली व्हेन आई वाज इन स्नो एक्सपोजर इंडिकेटर. आई एम श्योर यू गाइस हैव ऑलरेडी गॉन इनटू यूजिंग योर सेलफोन, क्लिकिंग ऑन द मैनुअल मोड, फिगरिंग आउट. वी सॉ अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल क्लिकिंग हाई स्पीड फोटोग्राफ्स ऑन सेलफोन्स एंड वी रियलाइज दैट इवन इफ इट शोज 1/1000 इज एक्चुअली नॉट 1/1000, बट डेफिनेटली देर इज समथिंग दैट इज हैपनिंग विद रिगार्ड टू शटर स्पीड ऑन योर सेलफोन एज वेल. So we tried doing long exposures on cell phone and got dramatic pictures. So yes, the cell phone is powerful and never close to mimicking your real DSLR camera, but you should know the basics. Then we understood why the cell phone camera doesn't give you awesome pictures. It's because if there is a blue light from tell the camera that these two lights have to be mixed
to achieve the right color balance. Otherwise, you'll see my face in a yellow tone or you'll see my face in a blue tone. So the right way of doing it is hold a piece of paper and tell them, white paper of course, and white, a lot of people also do gray balancing and black balancing. So white paper, when you tell the camera that this is white, the camera understands and readjusts, recalibrates. Sab jo lal wale jitne bhi tones hai, usko neela ki taraf le jata hai, or whatever is required. So the camera has to understand. So what is interesting here is, agar aap sunset ka ek photo khich rahe ho aur sun is generally very deep orange, and you don't want to keep that deep orange because the sea is blue, or it's white right now, it's supposed to be blue. If you tell your camera, there is a WB on your cell phone as well. So if you tell your camera, there are settings. I'll deep into this today. So if you tell the camera that this orange is not orange, it is white. So the camera automatically understands, oh, so this is white. So what it does is it reduces, say, 10 units of blue from the orange. And what it also does is on the white, it adds 10 units of blue. And the entire picture dramatically changes, and you'll get the blue, deep blue sky with a white, of course, white sky, or so you can place it somewhere in between where you get a blue sky as a red sky as well as a blue ocean. And that is where you have to figure out, take a call. These are settings that you have on your camera. We did this, we spoke about rule of thirds. I'm sure you guys have benefited from that. Rule of thirds is basically ensuring that, if you can see my mouse, it's ensuring that important things are placed on these corners, each of these spots. So your horizon could be on this line, or it could be on this line. You have to figure out. It cannot be at the center. Anything off center looks better. Applicable only to horizontal pictures, not square pictures. So today we are talking about post exposure. And phone pe bhi hum logon ne bahut baar ye dekha. I don't know, I'm sure you guys have done this. Maine isliye phone ka ek picture liya. I don't know, this is probably a Samsung phone, I don't know which one. I just picked up the image from the internet. And what is important is you have to, I'm sure we have already done this exercise before. We are trying to set the ISO base at 100 or whatever is the minimum available. Because can I have the chat screen please, because I can't see the chats here. Let me do a test. I can see my chats, but I can't see the rest of the chats. So let me just keep it here and see if I can get these. ISO has to be kept at the lowest possible number, and then you can, oh yes, okay, thank you. I can see it on the screen now. Reva, hi, thanks for tuning in. It must be early in the morning for you. And ISO has to be set at the lowest point unless you are really trapped with low light. I missed out to share a few of these things. So we talked about what you see on the screen right now is the AV, TV, NP, these semi-programmable semi-modes. We already spoke about that. One is shutter priority based, one is exposure based. You also have these images on the right hand side. So we'll talk about quickly a few things on the right hand side, which is the face. There is a face icon there on your camera. You have it also on a few cell phones. So what it does is it actually opens up your aperture so that you get the face in focus. The background is separated in a blur. So what it's doing is opening up the exposure to a point where you can see only the face in focus. So it gives you and if it is a dark low lit shot, it will also probably pop up a flash to fill up the space. The next one is the landscape mode, where it is better when you're using a wide angle lens, and it ensures that everything is in exposure, everything in exposure is in focus. And this pretty much ensures that everything is, and usually these are high bright lit exposures, and therefore you will get everything in sharp. So I would suggest that you should always try working on a manual mode. But if you have a birthday party or your friend's special sports day or whatever it is, and you cannot miss and you're really not good at it, then you can try these semi-automatic modes. So you have a sports mode, for example. We'll come to that later. So if you have a sports mode, then what you can do is use that, because that will ensure that you get the highest shutter speed possible during that environment, which means that kind of lighting or exposure. And it will ensure that you always get the highest possible shutter speed without compromising, depending on the lens that you have, depending on the camera that you have. You can also pre-lock the ISO, that you can define a range to it. So macro is this flower and the leaf. Macro is nothing but giving a close-up of anything that you want to go in. So ideally you should have a zoom lens here, but otherwise it really doesn't make too much of a difference. You can try doing it. I have not done it myself, so I would really not know, but I usually work on manual modes. So this may give you some advantage because it is there. Maybe it will give you that 1:1 ratio where you can work, and it also probably is an advanced version of the portrait mode where you get the focus in a specific point where the rest of it is dark. But this is completely a lens specific function, so I don't know how the camera plays a role on it or why do they give it in the camera itself. A macro lens is a specific lens and it has a macro button on it, and that is the only way you can get a macro image. You will not get it on this. I'm covering it because it's there. Sports mode I've already explained. Ye mode aap tabhi lena hai jab aapko koi specific high shutter speed ka kuch aapko capture karna hai, and that would mean that it will give you the highest possible shutter speed depending on the light. To agar aap andhere mein koi agar sports capture karna cha raha ho, then forget it. You will not get it because the highest shutter speed that the camera will probably calculate or calibrate is a 1/30, where you will not get good photographs. So understanding the basics on the manual mode is what will help you to a degree using these semi-automatic modes, but ultimately it is your understanding of your camera. So when you're driving a car, you have to understand the car. It's only when your brain and the car's engine is combined is that when you get your driving skills to the best of the ability. So you have to understand the camera, how it functions, why it functions the way given the settings, and that is when you start getting pictures that you can imagine in your head. So always start thinking from the camera's perspective. I've already seen photographs. I've seen a drastic improvement in your photographs starting from the first session where we were there, and today, till yesterday, these photographs have gone a long way in terms of achieving, in terms of picture quality, in terms of color compositions, in terms of using design elements, in terms of composition balance. And so night mode is something where it is pretty dark. Like right now it's almost getting dark outside, so when you're using a night mode, it will actually keep the exposure open for a longer time like you would do. But at the end, what it does is, if it is very dark, it starts it has a fill flash on your DSLR, even on your cell phone. It will give you a small flash, so it captures the face in the foreground, while because of the long exposure, it will get you the deep blue sky or whatever is there, the ambience light is raised, but your face will still remain sharp. Now all of these things are supposed to be done by you, by your brain, using the manual mode. So understanding that will give you better pictures, because a camera can only understand till a point. You know the exact situation on the location, and that is why you should always practice on your manual mode. Going back to presets, yes, this is important. Why I wanted to touch upon this is, I'm just touching upon all the loose ends that I have not done. Ye bahut zaruri cheez hai. Aap jab camera pe kabhi bhi aap save karte ho, I don't know if your cell phone camera will allow you to do that, but when you are capturing an image, the light travels from the lens, hits the sensor, right? What happens after that? It goes via the processor and gets saved. While it is saving, what is the setting that it is setting on, that it is saving that file on? That setting is this menu that you're seeing on the right hand side. These are preset menus that you have: standard, portrait, neutral. I'm just taking a snapshot. Inside each of these are nothing, you don't have to get confused. Isme confuse mat ho jaiye jyada, because ye jo presets hai is nothing but details, different combinations of these. So for example, sharpness is set to less than half. Why? Because it's a portrait setting. Portrait setting mein kya hota hai? You don't want to see the pimples or the small hairs, freckles on the face. So halka sa soft rakhna padta hai. And that is why you can do this yourself. So there are also user modes on this. Cell phones too have, some of the cell phones have a way where you can save your image. You can preset and predefine. So your image after capturing gets saved accordingly, not by the default. एंड एवरी टाइम ज़रूरी नहीं है कि हर फोटोग्राफ शार्प ही होना चाहिए. देर इज़ सम आर्टिस्टिक फील टू एन इमेज वेयर यू डोंट सी ईच एंड एवरी हेयर और मे बी द रिंकल्स दैट आर देयर, मे बी द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ फाइबर दैट कुड बी स्टिकिंग ऑन टू योर स्किन. एंड दैट देयरफॉर इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट यू ensure you figure out what is important for you. If it's an old lady and you want to show out the wrinkles, then yes, the sharpness has to be set to a high. The contrast is very important, like I told you last time. If you're doing a black and white photograph, or you have it in mind that you're working on contrast, contrast is something that we work on last time. So if you have a theme which is based on contrast, if you see that yes, this is a contrast picture, this is where I want to show the white wall with the shadow and the black wall with the highlighted bulb. If that is something that you want to do, then you have to set your contrast slightly higher on the camera, or you can keep it at standard. I shoot everything at -3 contrast or the minimum possible contrast. Saturation, ideally I keep saturation at -2. You can keep it at 0. Right now what you're seeing on your face right now on your screens is a 0 setting. So 0 is something that I would rather not use for a still image. I would rather keep it at -1, maybe -2. And it's a journey. That's why I keep telling you, it's your journey. आप जब शुरू करोगे फोटोग्राफ खींचना, शुरू में मेरा +3 saturation जब लगाता था, तब लगता था कि हाँ अब पिक्चर सही लग रहा है. But slowly as you mature, I wouldn't say mature, it's about exploring yourself, and you will realize that your likes and your preferences towards an image will slowly change. I love -3 contrast, -2 saturation at this point of time, and I focus more on the elements, the design, the communication that's coming out of the picture, rather than making it very on your face loud, unless of course it's Holi or something of that sort. I would love to have the colors bursting out on each picture. Agar Holi ka mausam hai to yes, colors aap 0 rakho, +1 bhi rakh sakte ho, it looks awesome. But otherwise, color tone is something that I couldn't understand for a long time. कलर टोन में यही होता है कि ये थोड़ा सा आपको पर्पलिश टिंच पे ले जाता है और एक तरफ ग्रीनिश टिंच पे ले जाता है. सो आई थिंक यू कैन प्ले ऑन दिस योर सेल्फ. आई एक्सीडेंटली डिस्कवर्ड इट दैट फॉर इंडियन स्किन विच इज़ ब्राउनिश इन कलर, इफ़ यू कीप द कलर टोन एट -1, यू गेट अ पिंकिश इमेज विच मेक्स देम लुक बेटर और वट एवर योर माइंड सेट वुड बी. आई वुडंट गो ऑन टू दैट फेयर एंड लवली डिबेट. But keeping it at 0 is perfectly fine. So you can figure out what works, because Indian skin is very brown. So if you can even get it slightly to the pinkish side, it may look different. And at the end of the day, it is not about how you only see your pictures. It's also about how people represent. So if you're doing it for people, then you have to ensure that these things are in place. आप अपने लिए खींच रहे हो तो आप purple बनाओ, brown बनाओ, अपने लिए कर रहे हो, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है. You can. I hope you guys are clear on this. Keep saying yes or a no so that I can go ahead. We have already 21 minutes into this show. So guys, please say clear, yes, understood or something of that sort on the chat box so that I can go ahead. While I continue to tell you more about the settings. So if on the left hand side is a normal image, you increase the contrast, you lose these white details here. This is just an example that I set it here. And if you have a +3 contrast, you really lose a lot of these white areas which go out of control. So if you are using a black and white which is high contrast image, then it looks wow. So what I've done is I've also shown you the black and white version of this image. And if it's a normal image and you increase the saturation here, of course there is a green tint. So when I increase the saturation, it became slightly greenish. Sometimes it always helps if you're not sure if there is a green tint or not, or there is a pink tint, or there is a yellow tint, and you're not sure whether it's there or not because your eyes are not trained. Kabhi kabhi hota hai hamare saath, mere saath bhi hota hai, aaj bhi hota hai. Dekh ke samajh mein nahi aata hai ki green tint aa raha hai ya nahi aa raha hai. Saturation ko full kar lo, aapko samajh mein aa jayega. Aap tint ko correct kijiye aur wapas usko saturation ko wahi level pe le aaiye. Maybe -1, 0, +1, whatever you want to, you can get it back there. Clear? So white balance. White balance is about telling the camera what is white, and you can break these rules to your advantage. So are you okay? Abhi tak samajh mein hai aapko? Because me going next to the next level, if you are not understanding this, you will not understand the next.
I can't see any chats. So let me start with, I'm going ahead. If you have any doubts, please put it on your chatbot and I will address. So let me go to the Canon software to show you what. So Canon software is a software which is given to you by the camera. You can use any software that is available. Some use Photoshop, some of them use you can use Photoshop, there is Lightroom, there are also a lot of these other softwares, free softwares. Google also have their softwares, desktop softwares I mean. So this is the camera build software. So let me open this up. So this is where I was trying to show you the brightness. So what you need to do is, yes of course, so aapko raw mein photograph khichne ka option agar hai, kai cameras mein bhi hota hai aur aajkal cell phone mein bhi aata hai, please ensure if you can, if you have the space, raw captures saves at 3x the size. So if a JPEG is generally what the format is, JPEG generally saves at about, if it is saving, it depends on how big the megapixel saving rate is. We also understood about megapixels last time, that it's all how flawed the entire system is. So if your say image is getting saved at 4 MB, if it's a raw picture, it will probably get saved at 16 MB, and because it saves all the information for you to edit, and post the edit, you still retain a lot of these. So this is a raw image here, and if it's a JPEG image, I wouldn't have been able to do it. So I can increase it to say till this point, maybe 1.5 stops, if you can see, and I still have details here. I'm not okay, you still have details, they're out of focus here. So let's go here, let's go higher. 1, 3, 2 stops, you still have details here. So if I reduce the highlights, let me see if I can still retain the details. Yes, I still have the details. I can go higher. So look at the amount of flexibility that you get. Bas, isse zyada nahi. I think this is the last point. Two steps. So if you are using a JPEG image, you won't be able to increase it by two stops. You will get all white. There wouldn't be any details here. And you're getting these details because it's saved on RAW. So let's go back to the image. Now I was talking about white balance. Now there is a green tint here. Why is there a green tint? The green tint is probably because the light which is coming through, in this case it was a plastic roof, has a green tint to it. How do I correct it? You have to tell the camera what is white. Similarly here you have to tell the software what is white. So this is actually doing the same exercise on post. If you have a raw image, you can do that. You can also do it if you have a JPEG image, but it's not that dramatic, it's not that effective. So all you have to do is just pick up this white balance adjustment, and as far as I remember, water can be white, but this tablecloth could be creamy. This, maybe this paper box is white. So I'll just tell the software that this is white, right? So look at this picture. Now it's become suddenly very bluish in color. Maybe the paper box is slightly yellowish, or your brain will take 2 seconds to register. If that is the case, you just look around and then look back into the picture. Abhi bhi agar aapko slightly gray bluish lag raha hai, to shayad bluish tint ko hatane ke liye aap yahan pe minor adjustments kar sakte ho. So I want to go away. So on the left you can see this is blue, on the right hand side you can see red, on the top is green, on the left is a combination of red and blue. So I would want to go slightly towards the reddish warm tint. So maybe pull it here and see. And as I told you, this is the trick that I always, it works for me. I increase the saturation to the full possible amount. Now you will exactly know whether your tint is correct or not. It looks perfect to me at this point of time. So now I can reduce it to whatever I was. If it was zero, I would rather keep it at zero. And then I can play with the contrast, which is I can keep it at -2. I can increase the contrast even more. If I want to increase the contrast, actually I should have given you a live demo. So if I give you an increased contrast, it will look better if I give you, if I reduce the saturation. So it look, gives you a more realistic feel. So let me open another picture to show you what white balance is. Hang on. What happened?
Okay, let me open this picture. Now, this picture is, I know this picture, where the light, the daylight is coming from the backside. ये जो रोशनी पीछे जो लाइट आ रहा है ये ट्यूब लाइट का नहीं है, बाहर से रोशनी है, दिन का रोशनी है. एंड द टॉप पार्ट एज आई सेड इज स्लाइटली ग्रीनिश येलो ऑन द टॉप. दैट इज, देर इज अ प्लास्टिक सीलिंग, दैट्स वेयर द डे लाइट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम. एंड दैट इज व्हाई द टू कलर्स आर डिफरेंट, वन इज येलोइश एंड वन इज ब्लू. नाउ इन माई केस हियर, इफ आई टेल द कैमरा दैट द वाइट इज द ग्लास, सो लेट मी पिक दिस अप एंड डू इट. ये एक्चुअली आप कैमरा पे भी कर सकते हो, वाइट बैलेंस जब आप करते हो तो यही होता है, मैं आपको दिखा रहा हूँ. तो इफ़ यू टेल द कैमरा दैट दिस इज वाइट, दिस पोर्शन इज वाइट, तो आप वाइट बैलेंस अगर ऑटो पे नहीं रखो, आजकल ऑटो पे भी काफ़ी, आई एम टेलिंग यू द ऑटो कैमराज आर वेरी गुड इवन टुडे, सो दे विल अंडरस्टैंड, दे डू दैट एडजस्टमेंट. बट इफ यू टेल द कैमरा दैट दिस इज वाइट, सी वॉट हैपन्स. इट हैज़ मेड दिस वाइट, बट बिकॉज आई हैव टोल्ड दैट दिस इज वाइट, हर चीज़ बाकी जितने भी चीज़ें हैं वो सब रेड हो गया, बिकॉज द कैमरा इज नॉट टेकिंग दैट एज वाइट. So it's adding red to everything else. At the same point of time, if I say that maybe this dhokla or whatever it is, if this is white, it will add blue to everything else. So let me do that. See, this is how dramatic white balance can be. And so I'm getting, now it's looking too bluish to me. And it really doesn't work for me because it's looking artificial. Remember, I always told you that the photograph that you have has to look the same way. So the way that you saw it on location, it has to replicate or it has to look the same. आप जब location पे जाते हो आपको दिखाई देता है कुछ, और brain को जो दिखाई देता है उसको replicate करने की कोशिश कीजिए. आप जो कर रहे हो, you are trying to replicate and reframe it for the people to see. So therefore, the blue was never there, but I'll have to live with it because my brain cancels it out. The camera will not. The camera will either take the blue or it will ignore the blue. So to get the right, because this is my subject, I will probably start by using his shirt as white. So I'm taking it for granted that this is white, or maybe this bowl that is white. So let's take it with his shirt. So I tell the shirt is white and this is the closest I can get. So let me go close and check. So for what is important for me is this image, his smile. It should be in focus, the detail should be in focus, the chai should be in focus. His face has got a lot of red tint, and the red tint I cannot remove because the chai tint is also red. So if I remove the red, the chai will go become whitish in color, which I don't want. Why? We want to retain that color. So what is the solution? You have to maybe just go in onto his face and remove the saturation manually on Photoshop, or maybe using another tool. But you have to figure out what works for you better. I would, and there are no details on the face, so there is a shadow option here. You can increase the slider of the shadow, because whatever is dark will come appear brighter. So I would rather live with this showing his face and his smile than not showing anything. So I would rather go with her. Yeah, this is so much better. So I hope you're understanding what this, I just wanted to show you what this white balance does. I hope it's interesting. So if you're telling the camera that this is white, the camera automatically transforms everything accordingly. So ye white hai to baki sab kuch blue kar dega, agar aap isko white bologe to baki sab ko red kar dega, because the camera is obeying what you're saying. So you have to figure out, a lot of times the auto balance is on white, is on auto, and that's perfectly fine. But if you really want to break those rules, you get onto the auto mode, get off the white balance auto mode, and you can use different presets. Like on the phone, you have got tungsten, you have got a tube fluorescent, you have got shady, you've got those small icons there, right? You can use those and play with it even on your cell phone. So can we have the visual back? Let me go back to, I hope you have understood what I was trying to say. Let's go back to the slides and say yes to saving it. Okay. So, okay. Done. So, these are the settings on your screen. You can see a cloudy scale. So, This entire thing is the spectrum of white balance. So if you want a warmish tint, it will be bulb, then it will be a tube light, flash. Flash is actually white light. Daylight is subject to what time it is, because in the morning it will be red in color, or dopahar ka samay, depends on which side you are shooting. So if you are shooting against the sun, it will be deep blue. Bahut log bolte hai ki wow, ye deep blue sky kahan se mil gaya aapko? It's just because you are opposite to the sun. So if you are opposite to the sun, you get a deep blue color. If you are facing the sun, you will get a white exposure. So always try to shoot opposite to the sun, because then you also get your subject front lit. तो आप कैमरा से अगर खींच रहे हो, सेलफोन से भी खींच रहे हो, वन बेसिक रूल दैट यू नीड टू कीप इन माइंड, आप हमेशा याद रखिएगा, जब भी आप फोटो खींच रहे हो, फ्रेंड्स का कुछ भी, अचानक देखिए सूरज किस तरफ है, बिकॉज दैट्स योर मेन सोर्स ऑफ लाइट. सूरज किधर से आ रहा है और उसका ऑपोजिट को लेके खींचे, एंड इफ इट इज स्काई, इट विल लुक ब्लू, ट्रस्ट मी. सो आई एम क्विकली गोइंग ऑन टू, ओके, आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू द वाइट बैलेंस, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन कॉन्ट्रास्ट, सैचुरेशन, वाइट बैलेंस. Now I ask you guys to download this software called Snapseed. Snapseed is one basic tool that I use. I prefer this software because it's giving you a lot of these options where you can choose from in terms of editing, but except for one where I cannot, if I want to merge two pictures into one, I can't do that. So there are times when there are probably happy birthday wishes that I have to make on a group. So there are two people. What if there are two people who has the birthday on the same day or within that group? I have to get in two pictures and merge them as one. That is something that I can't do here, but approximately rest everything is taken care on this software itself. It's on the phone and it's pretty brilliant. I'll just do a demo of this. Google Photos also has a lot of time. Instagram, I don't have to explain. I'm sure you guys have tried out all the filters. The step that you go after your filter is where you also get editing software. I think we quickly take you through this. So I have my phone today, I have got a camera. See, there's nothing. If you can see on my screen here, there is nothing that's coming on the live chat. So let me go to Insta first and show you. I hope my screen is okay. Okay, so let me go, I click plus, let me pick up an image. Okay, let's pick up this image, right? This is the image that I just picked up, clicked an hour before, so that I can share with you. Now, once you do that, you go to next, and then you have these filters. You can just pick up any of these filters. They're like pretty simple. Some have a green tint, some are high. So what are they doing? They're basically just giving you different preset combinations. Some have a blue tint on it, some are high contrast, low contrast. There is something called edit here. So if you press the edit button, that is where you get all your settings. I'm sure if you don't know, try exploring this part. So adjust would mean you are turning, tilting it. So this looks like a better frame. So you said done, then you go to brightness, maybe, I don't know, maybe this would do. I'm just showing you random samples. Contrast, I don't want contrast. What does it look like? No, these dark areas are gone. So I'd rather keep it slightly. Okay, I think it's okay. Keep it somewhere. Done. Then I go to structure. Structure is nothing but increasing the sharpness here. In terms of photography, structure would actually mean enhancing the shadows and reducing. So pretty much something like the HDR format. But here structure is only, as I can see, it's only sharpness. Yeah, it's also increasing the contrast a bit. Okay, so then we have warmth. Warmth would mean nothing but white balance. It's the blue tint. On the other side, it's a red tint. So if it's a sunset, probably this would look better. I don't know. So I'll keep it slightly towards the warmer shade, because right now here, this is completely neutral. So I'll keep it slightly warmer so that there is, because the sunlight is coming from the sides. It's just before sunset. And therefore, I would like to keep this warm tone. I want the sky to go blue. Maybe saturation is my next spot. So I increase the saturation slightly. But these are getting too yellow, which means I need to go back to warmth and reduce the warmth. Yeah, this works for me. Color would mean, so this is just adding. So there are two types of colors, shadows and highlights. Shadows would mean giving in that color tint in those dark areas, wherever there are dark areas. So I would rather stick to shadow. For shadows, I'll stick to a blue. No, blue is too dark. These are too dark, so I'll rather stay with black. And highlights, I would maybe go with blue to enhance the sky. No, this is too deep. I wish they had a slider where you can control these. So all these filters that you get, only do something, these, use these. So let's not use this, I'll cancel. And then there is a fade button. So fade is doing nothing but actually enhancing your shadows. I'm doing this for the first time, guys. I just joined Instagram a year back because I realized I didn't want to be left alone. So this is also doing nothing but it's increasing your shadows. So let's not touch this. Okay, this is specifically called shadows. Vignette is something that everybody does. Charo taraf se kala kar do and it looks like a wow photo. I don't think that's true. What the vignette is there to ensure that the viewer, whenever they're looking at the image, looks at the point where you want to. So if it's a pretty looking girl or small two kids playing, or there is a specific thing that you want to highlight, then vignette works. Vignette is nothing but a limitation of the lens, where cheap lenses actually cannot illuminate the sides and therefore it goes dark. So this is actually something not to be proud of. Photographers actually hide vignetting when it happens in a real sense. But yes, if you want to project the center, the portion that's right at the center, then maybe yes, a slight vignetting also helps. So you can try doing that. Tilt shift is what? Oh, that's interesting. So it gives you a blur. So radial would mean circle. Okay, so this is trying to mimic a lens blur where only the center point is at focus. No, I don't need that. And that's about it. So let me not post this. So I specifically have my Insta where I only post images. So all these images that you see on my Insta post here is only photo, cell phone photography. And on the iClick, I share the pictures that have been clicked only by a basic camera. Why I wanted to show you this was not here. I just got, sorry, off track. So Snapseed, yes. So I'm sure you guys have downloaded this picture. I'll just show you the basics. So this is the picture here. You've got tools and the basic sharpness tools. If you click here, you'll get brightness, contrast, sharpness, ambience. Ambience is nothing but bringing down the, it's more of the HDR mode. So it brings down the highlights and raises the shadows. If you can see the difference, this is what it does in the opposite way and this is how it is. So let's go back there. Ambience, highlight, shadows, I've already told you. Warmth is something that's important, where basically you can cheat the or recreate the color balance, which is blue and yellow tone, whatever you want to. Once you select, then there are a lot of other things that I like about here on this software is perspective. Like this is a wide angle image. If you notice that the building is not straight, it's like this, because my camera, the front camera has got a wide angle. It's slightly wide angle, so it tends to distort everything. So all I have to do is just press the magic button here. It'll figure out what is right, what is not. No, it couldn't. Did it? No. So I can press this and then I can pull the image to make it, I can correct this. Interesting. And you can press to check. No, I didn't do that. Okay, you have to first say okay. And then you can press to see the change. See, this is the change that it has been. It has corrected almost. So this is slightly more. I need to do it. I'll do, redo this. Undo. I hope you are liking this because it really works for me. Go back to free. Maybe I overdid it. Slightly less would work. Yeah. There is a hint of distortion, but this works for me. And brush is very interesting, where you can enhance. So if there's a sky that I want, you can pick up exposure. So I can reduce exposure minus, so I can increase here. So can you see this? And I want to increase the exposure on the buildings. Just one stop on the buildings here. Maybe two stops here to see the green. It's very dark. Oh, it's looking unnatural now. Tell me if you get bored. I'll just switch over. Okay, then
Saturation, yes, I need more saturation in the buildings here. I'll just have a touch of it. So I'll increase the saturation to highlight the greens. I don't know if the blue will look better with more bluish tint. Maybe I'll add the colors here so that it doesn't look like it's treated. Okay. Temperature I can control. So yes, I would want to bring it to the bluish tone here because it's slightly more yellow. Okay, and exposure slightly here on this side, so a 0.3 would do, just a touch of it. Okay, so when you press, you'll see the image that it was before, and this is what it is now. Can you see the difference? The sky is looking better, that is more HDR. The greens are bright, it looks like almost the sun is touching this area here. And let me see what more can I do. And you can, there are tons of stuff that you can do. I'm just touching upon the basics. Very interesting. So I can just put, I can say happy birthday. Or let's say Eid Mubarak, today is Eid. Eid Mubarak. And you put it there. And you can also choose your fonts. You guys, you can, white looks good to me. There are a lot of fonts that you can choose from. A lot of stuff that you can do, so you can experiment, do whatever. I think this is okay. Eid Mubarak, you can tap again and type, so it'll say Eid Mubarak Mumbai. That's the skyline, Mumbai skyline there. And let's put a smiley. Okay, so okay, this is going out, so let me see if I can change the setting to a single line. Is this looking okay? Yeah, maybe there. So there it is. So if you press, you'll see what the original image is, and this is what it is. Now if you want a second text, you can just double click here. What I do is to create a background, it doesn't have a background. So what I do is I generally use this and I create whatever I have to. So if it's a line here, or if I want to create a line here, you can just do whatever you want to make it smaller maybe. Like a cursor on the left hand side, you can keep it on the right hand side. I don't know what looks better. No, left looks better. So maybe it doesn't, so you can just cross it, it will go. So then you save or you export as a file. That's about it, right? So I hope you have. Let's go back to YouTube. Let me see if I can see your, oh, YouTube is gone. Oh yes, I can see your chats now. It's functional. Great. So keep typing in. I want you, nobody's type, whether you guys want, whether you want to understand lighting. Lighting is a very important part of photography, just the basics maybe. So I'll just put the screen here and we'll continue. So what's the time right now? 47. Okay, so did we jump? So Snapseed is something that we understood. Remember guys, it's always, a lot of people don't understand this. Bahut logo ko ye lagta hai ki treatment karna ya post karna ya koi bole agar photograph ko better karna hai, sirf color bada dete, saturation bada dete ya to contrast bada dete. That's never the original intent. If you really want to make a photograph look good, people to react, admire it, फर्स्ट कंटेंट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आपको सोचना पड़ेगा कि उसमें मैसेज क्या है, क्या उसमें वो इवेंट है या कुछ ऐसा स्पेसिफिकली चीज़ है जो दिल को छू जाता है. यू कैन क्लिक इमेजेस, शो इट टू योर फ्रेंड्स एंड यू विल रियलाइज दैट सम इमेजेस अट्रैक्ट देम मोर. इट्स बिकॉज दे कैन कनेक्ट टू इट. सो सी इफ यू कैन कनेक्ट फोटोग्राफ्स विद पीपल, कैन कम्युनिकेट, देयर हैज़ टू बी एन इमोशन इनसाइड इट. और जब आप फोटो खींचते हो तो वहाँ पे फिर आप देखिए लाइट किस तरफ से आ रहा है, आप वाइट बैलेंस कैसे करना चाहते हो. आपने एलिमेंट्स, हमने चैप्टर 4 में सीखा था एलिमेंट्स का, लाइंस जो होते हैं आपके, सर्कल्स, इमेजेस, ट्रायंगल्स हर जगह होता है. मैंने आपको दिखाया था रेक्टेंगल्स, ट्रायंगल्स, सर्कल्स एवरीवेयर. सो हाउ डू यूज़ देम स्मार्टली
and then create a composition with that rule of thirds. Rule of thirds के साथ use करके जब आप करोगे तो आपका photograph wow आएगा. Contrast अगर मिल रहा है तो nothing like it. ज़रूरी नहीं है कि सब चीज़ उस situation में हो, लेकिन जितना ज़्यादा हो सके try to use them. Cellphone is a great way to start photography because you don't have to really keep worrying about exposure controls, shutter speeds. या आप DSLR में जाओगे तो वो भी एक tension रहता है. So composition is something that you start practicing on cellphone before you start working on better photograph, which is the DSLR, and that is when you have to focus on right exposure, which is shutter speed and f-stops. F-stop is lens dependent, shutter speed is camera dependent. Agar aapko ye miss ho gaya lesson, to aap please dekhiyega. I think it was episode 4 or episode, no, it was episode 2. So I think we are wrapping up early today, or did I go too fast? So if you guys want, I can keep talking for hours. If you ask me questions on the past entire 4-5 session that we had, I'll just quickly keep addressing them because we have time to for a change. Generally kabhi aise hua hi nahi hai ki aaj tak kabhi time mila ho, ki I always keep on thinking last 15 minutes will be for the Q&A session, lekin aisa kabhi hua hi nahi. We always spilled to 1 hour 15 minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes every session, and it's the first time then we have actually been able to get some extra time. So semi-automatic modes, the ones that I showed you initially, are excellent if you really are not sure that your skill sets are perfect and you miss the moment. You may miss the moment, you're not sure. Bhai ka shaadi hai, dost ka birthday hai, or it's your brother who is taking a race and it's like a football match or whatever, or it's a low light situation. Don't take a chance. If you're not sure, go for a semi-automatic mode. You will get better pictures. When you're practicing, practice street photography using a basic cell phone will help. Look at the, so I okay, great. So we will do lighting on the next session. Thank you, Suman. And I think what is important is, guys, you are not typing in. If you don't type, I will not get to know. Please type karte jaiye, and it's a live chat, so I'll get a type. If you type, I'll get to see in the next 5 minutes or five seconds, sorry. So what is important is you have to understand A, your content, B, your message. Your brain has to process and see it the way the camera does. We see it in a very different way. I've already shared how we see it differently from a camera, and that is why you need to understand the camera to see it from the camera perspective. Lenses play a very important role. All of this combined, I think you'll start using, when you start practicing street photography, that is when you'll start getting the real understanding of how to respond to a situation, because every corner is different. Every few steps, the situation would change. And when you actually have to catch that moment, that's just happening there. It's not planned. It doesn't give you a warning. You have to be alert and you catch it there. That is when you'll start realizing that you need to be fast. You'll miss a lot of interesting moments, interesting pictures in the beginning, interesting situations. But slowly as you get better, आप जैसे जैसे आप देखते जाओगे कि आपका पिक्चर्स बेटर होते जाएगा. क्योंकि ऐसा नहीं है कि पिक्चर्स बेटर हो रहा है क्योंकि सिचुएशन ज़्यादा बेटर है, क्योंकि आप अच्छे मोमेंट्स को लूज़ नहीं करोगे. आप होने के पहले देखोगे. सो इफ़ यू सी अ डॉग रनिंग क्रॉसिंग द स्ट्रीट एंड यू नो देर इज़ अ व्हीकल कमिंग फ्रॉम द अदर साइड, यू विल बी रेडी एंड वेटिंग टू गेट द डॉग्स रिएक्शन. ऑफकोर्स द डॉग विल जंप आउट एंड द कार विल ब्रेक. एंड इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू रियली एक्सपेरिमेंट, इफ़ यू रियली गुड एट इट, यू कैन यूज अ जूम लेंस एंड कैप्चर the driver's expression at that point of time. So there are a lot of stuff that you can do. You can take expressions of the people around when they see that, when they hear that noise of the brakes screeching, and these things will slowly help you to create better pictures. Don't just sit there. When you see a good frame, look at it and say, wow, this is a nice frame. But wait for things to happen, like I shared during my session 3, I think. Wait for a moment, it will happen. If it's an awesome moment, it will happen. So can I have the chat screen, please? Because I can't see any chats coming. I can only see, okay, Polashi. No, not all of them are coming. Okay, hi Shweta. I'm just reading your sessions. Quickly type in whatever you guys have as questions right now. I'll just try to address them. If there's anything else that you... Thanks. I can see the chats now coming up on my screen. So just type in whenever you, whatever you want to. If there is anything that you would like to know. I went pretty quick today, or maybe there was not much to share today. Maybe I could have included flashlight, but I didn't want to put cram in too many things because it's very confusing to capture them. So for assignment, I would like you to click pictures, basic pictures, and see how you can enhance them. How you can enhance them to a point where it looks wow. So don't just use vignetting, the black thing all around the image. That works, that is effective. But beyond that, see if you can create a wow black and white image. I think black and white image is a very big challenge because that is when you will have to hunt for contrast situations. So if you are up to it, if you are really, really up to it, try going for black and white photographs. Try clicking pictures normally and then increasing the contrast, or maybe just putting the saturation to zero. That would help. So looking forward to your photographs on the group. And if there's anything missing, you can always share. Lighting is something that I would like to share on a separate series, and maybe just people who are interested could join in. It's not really a necessity for photographs, but understanding lighting is very important. Lighting could also mean the sun. You shoot clicking photographs, so when you click photographs, it's always using a light. It could be a sun, it could be a reflection of the sun, it could be a cloudy screen light through the clouds coming to you, it could be bouncing of lights through the buildings, through a glass, and anything that has light can only become a photograph. Without light, it's darkness, it's black. So there is light, there is photography. So understanding how to use these interestingly in a dynamic way to enhance your photographs, like we use the other elements, I think that's also another aspect to photography. So I am already seeing people sharing your photographs on iClick. Please do that. Most welcome. It's your group, it's not my group, it's your page. Please share, and I'm always there for any guidance if you want to. And what else? So I am not getting any chats today, so there are no questions, I hope. So if you guys don't ask me, I'll start asking you guys. What else? Yeah, I guess it is important that you guys understand lens and everything else that I have shared. Maybe I'll do one more session next week. Next Saturday is okay, I hope. Next Saturday, let's do a session on lighting. Lighting would mean there are three types of light. Let me just tease you for that episode. There are three types of lights. Let me go back to the last screen. There are three types of lights in an ideal situation. So when we shoot on a studio, when we shoot for actors, when we shoot for commercials, there are three lights that are important. One is the source light, which is the main light. One is the fill light. So the fill light removes the shadows from the nose, and there is one backlight, which is called the rim light or the backlight, which enhances your visuals. To separate, like we use separation using the lens by blurring the background, you can also separate the background by creating a rim light. So that's how easy it is, and all of these combined together makes a great picture. So that is if image is 3D, then this is probably 4D. So there are a lot of dimensions to every photograph: emotion, lens that you use, the objects that you use, how you enhance those photographs using post, how you use light on location to enhance those photographs. All of these combined together make an awesome photograph. So I'm wrapping it up early today. I hope you have learned something at least from today's episode, and let's catch you next week, the last episode. And if you have questions, please WhatsApp me so that I can address them before the show and then take them forward and put them on the slides so that they can be addressed. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.